We live in a data-centric world today. In one day, this is how much data is generated. How is the industry processing these massive amounts of data generated? It boils down to innovations in both hardware and software architectures. Let's take a look at how software architectures are evolving to maximize the usefulness of this data flood. We've been writing software for over 60 years now, and the recipe is well understood. When you have work to do, you break it down into smaller and smaller pieces of work. The process recurses. It's like a fractal. Ultimately, at the lowest level, work is broken down into atomic instructions. The entire process results in what is known as a computational tree. It can get pretty complex. The software is often referred to as monolithic software, and that's not a good thing. To reduce the complexity, software is grouped by layers of functionality. Within a layer, the unit of composition is a function. To execute a computation, you push some data into the tree. It percolates through the tree, and you get a response. It is not uncommon nowadays for sophisticated computations to result in billions of instructions being executed through the monolithic computational tree. The process repeats itself for the next piece of data. This is a very sequential process. Multithreading is often used to improve speed, but it can result in software that is hard to write and debug. Clearly, this classic approach is not without challenges. It turns out that there is a modern approach to software development. It's called microservices. Each microservice implements a portion of the monolithic computational tree. The microservices are stitched together to implement the same functionality as before. Data flows from one microservice to the next. The microservices are inherently asynchronous. Since each microservice has a different processing bandwidth, it needs to have a queue to match the inbound and outbound bandwidth and make sure the queues stay small. You start multiple instances of each service. That way, the aggregate bandwidth of your services is what you need. This approach to scaling is called scale out, where the number of nodes increases as the data volume increases. The software designated to manage the instantiation, as well as other management functions, such as teardown, is known as the control plane. In contrast, the software that performs the task itself is known as the data plane. Simply put, the control plane controls the data plane. We believe that the recasting of software in terms of microservices and the separation between data plane and control plane is very general, and in fact, can be broadly applied to any software. What makes the modern microservices approach possible? In the classic approach, the monolithic software is instantiated on one compute node. In fact, it is difficult to partition the software to run across multiple nodes or even threads. Microservices, on the other hand, are purpose-built to run across as many compute nodes as necessary. The invention of scale-out infrastructure has enabled microservices to be implemented seamlessly and flexibly. Because microservices are implemented across multiple compute nodes, the availability of a fast and reliable network fabric enables data to be moved around quickly and efficiently. Further, as data flows across multiple compute nodes within the data center, more commonly known as east-west traffic, a robust approach to east-west security is paramount. Benefits of the modern microservices approach. To process increasing amounts of data, the classic approach needs bigger, faster computing. This approach is called scale-up. Scale-up was the dominant way of scaling when Moore's law was alive and well, and silicon and compute performance was doubling every 2 years. With the modern approach, computing performance is increased simply by adding more nodes to the infrastructure. This more flexible approach to scaling is called scale-out, and it circumvents the slowdown of Moore's law. With the classic approach, the computation you need to perform needs to be matched to your hardware. Since the computations have varied requirements on hardware, you need to oversize your hardware to account for the superset of requirements, and that's wasteful. With the modern approach, you can easily run a microservice on a composed set of disaggregated resources matched to its specific requirements, leaving unused resources for other microservices. With the classic approach, whenever there is a failure, hardware or software, not only is isolating the fault a complicated and time-consuming process, but addressing the issue often requires interrupting the service. Mitigating failures requires a redundant big iron, which is an expensive solution. With the modern approach, when a failing microservice is detected, a new instantiation can be created in its place. Software is constantly evolving, whether for bug fixes or new improvements. Deploying new software while it is simultaneously running is nearly impossible with the classic approach. With the modern approach, however, it's easy. The microservice with the new software is instantiated. Both old and new microservices coexist until all requests are intended for the new service. Then the old service is removed. This approach allows for rolling upgrades of software. With the classic approach, performance is optimized by counting instructions and recombining functions to get the benefits of inlining, and that extends to recombining functions across layers as well. With the modern approach, all that needs to happen is a straightforward matching of bandwidth. If a microservice becomes the bottleneck, simply instantiate more of it, and all that can be done automatically by the control plane. If after applying all possible software techniques, more speed is still needed, you can turn to hardware acceleration. With the classic approach, discrete accelerators can be used, but the synchronous nature of the architecture reduces the benefits. The microservices, on the other hand, are inherently queue-based and asynchronous, allowing entire microservices to be easily implemented in hardware. To sum it up, there are many benefits a microservices-based modern approach brings. Improved scalability, server resource utilization, fault tolerance and ease of continuous deployment, performance optimization, and hardware acceleration. We call the classic approach to writing software compute-centric, while the modern way is data-centric. Our prediction is that all modern software applications will be written to be data-centric going forward.